Hello and welcome to Efficient Strategy Gaming. Today we had another Dev Diary drop from Paradox Studios, and it is on Hearts of Iron 4. So we have Developer Diary Ethiopia number 2, and we've got a new presenter here, Avi B. And what they're showing off is the new communist and fascist focus trees. And there's going to be a surprise here at the end, so stick around till the end of the video. So if you guys don't have a lot of time, I'm just going to get right into it and summarize this. We're not going to go through everything that is said in the developer diary, but I just wanted to share with you guys the good stuff that they're doing in Paradox. It is quite a long developer diary, so you might appreciate the summary here. So please leave a like and subscribe if you do. So the first thing that they go over here is the fascist path. And I've got my notes down in the description box, so check that out. Leave me comments whether you go the fascist path or the communist path. But the first thing you could do is the nobles of Ethiopia are kind of worried about getting taken over and dethroned, as it were. By the Italians. So they have a new idea and they want to align with the fascists. It describes in the dev diary here that you're able to do that. And there's two flavors of how to do that. I'm not entirely sure if this is collaborationist flavor of the fascist path or the coup flavor. But basically they describe that you can either become an integrated part of Italy, or you can kind of negotiate your own state and then kind of have Victor Emanuel I as your overseer. And you get a spirit right here, Victor Emanuel I of Ethiopia, and you can modify this spirit and improve it. As you can see, it gives you positive stability, but a crippling political power gain there. And as you go through the focus trees, you can buff that national spirit. So going down the line here, they go through the different things that you're able to acquire from fascist Ethiopia. I believe that this shows you the splinter route of creating a coup. So you can initially negotiate with the fascists to cooperate with them, and then you kind of backstab them at the end. And you can create the Italian-Ethiopian Empire down here at the end of this fascist route. And that gives you cores on a lot of territory. You can see that you could backstab Italy. You can align with Italy. Or you can kind of align with the states around Ethiopia. And you can also ask other powers to give you arms, such as the United Kingdom, Soviet Union, and France. So this is our enemy's enemy focus here. And that's a way to combat the Italians. Another way that they share to combat the Italians is to raid the Italian depots, which I think would be better, because not only do you take 1,000K guns from Italy, but you receive those guns. So that's a 2K net. Whereas if you just get it from other countries, then it looks like you could receive 4,000 guns. Perhaps you could receive more guns, but you're not taking those guns away from Italy. The next thing that comes up, they're going to show you the communist focus tree, which is incredibly interesting. So as we go down the line here, you can create a coup against Haile Selassie where you can exile him or lock him up. So this is inviting the communists into your country. You can go several different directions here, a call out to the world or Soviet aid. And as you go down, you can receive either generals or guns and airplanes from the Soviet Union. I wouldn't suggest taking the generals if they look like this. So this field marshal is not very powerful, and I'm sure you get an option for a field marshal as Ethiopia. I'd rather take the guns and the airplanes route, and you can see that in the focus tree here. So if you accept Soviet aid, so you're basically accepting them into the Italo-Ethiopian war, they will give you rifles and airplanes or generals and armor. The armor, I don't know if you could support as Ethiopia, because obviously you're going to need oil. You're going to need to replace that armor. That might be a bridge too far right there. And then going down the line here, you could see that you can ask the Soviets to mediate between Italy and Ethiopia and get involved in the war and try to perhaps negotiate a peace. After you negotiate a peace, a communist peace with Italy, then you can choose several paths to go down here. So the Soviet Union demands foreign policy alignment. So you become a puppet of the Soviet Union. And the other path that you can go down is to create an African Union. So it's kind of interesting here. So you have all these events and decisions that cost political power to spark uprisings in all these areas if you go communist. And then after you spark the uprisings, it looks like you can then combine them together to become initially democratic as you fight against the Italians, but then you can form the African unity over here, the African Union. You splinter off as democratic. So the People's Democratic Republic of Ethiopia. So this is after you settle things with the Italians. And as you can see, there's Somali Democratic Republic, Eritrean Democratic People's Republic. So you splinter off into all these democratic states. And then, as you can see, you can form the African Union at the bottom, where you then become kind of the overlord of all these states as the player of the game. Very interesting that you start off communist and end up democratic, I would assume. But I do believe that this is the way to go. OP Ethiopia, this appears to be the best way to gain the most power as Ethiopia, because you will get cores on all this territory, or most of it. But that is going to be the end of the Dev Diary. So to summarize, you could go fascist, you could go communist, into democratic. And if we go up here to the top, we can take a look at the focus tree overall again. This looks like the far right-hand side of the focus tree. And as you can see, you start communist here. You end with the African Union, which is much like the EU, and they do have like a NATO clause where you become kind of a defensive organization. I think that that's before you form the African Union, but all those democratic states that splintered off, you kind of have a defensive agreement with them that if one is attacked, everyone's going to join the war. And then the fascist path, I don't really like it as much, because you have to collaborate initially with Italy in order to backstab them, and you get several debuffs from this. It does seem easier just to go communist and then kind of align with the communists, perhaps get some equipment from the communists here, and then get all the goodies from the communist branch. It looks like they have over here an extra research slot. Liberate French Somaliland. You could start taking surrounding territories, and then eventually form the African Union. So I think that this is my plan for OP Ethiopia in the future when the By Blood Alone DLC comes out. But thank you guys for following this. I know I just breezed through this real quick, but hopefully that's a summary of the developer diary. I'm super excited about this and all the changes that Paradox has to Hearts of Iron 4. Please leave a like and subscribe if you enjoy this type of content, and I'll see you on the next one.